So good morning, my dear students. So today I'm going to start logarithm. In this, we have to learn one first important definition called exponential function. Exponential function. Okay. So the definition for exponential function is a function f of x is equal to a power x. A function is of the form f of x is equal to a power x, where here the base a must be positive constant other than 1, and the exponent x is any real number. So here the base a is a constant, exponent x is a variable, and that variable may take any real number. So such function a power x is called exponential function. What we call exponential function. So this function is called exponential function. So generally this exponential function, we use these exponential functions in calculating growth and decline of population. And also it has many applications. Just I discussed that example. Okay. So now if you observe this function f of x is equal to a power x, it is defined for all real numbers x. So that means you can input any real number for x. You can input for this function any real x. So that means the domain of this function, is all real numbers. So now for these values of x, the function value a power x is always positive. The value of a power x for any real number x is always positive. Thus, the range of this function contains only positive real numbers. Okay, so thus the domain of this function is set of all real numbers, range is positive real numbers. Now I'm going to discuss the graph of this function, and here we will get two cases will arise. A is greater than one case and A is less than one case. And A is greater than one and A is less than one. A is less than one means you have to understand A is lie between 0 and 1 throughout this topic. Okay. Now, I am going to draw the graph of this function. Graph of y is equal to f of x is equal to a power x. So clearly, if x value 0, what is a power 0? 1. So when x value 0, what is y value? 1. That means the function crosses the y axis at 0, 1. And also, it is always positive. So it is always positive. The graph of this a power x completely above x axis. That means no part of the graph is below x axis. Also the graph of this function never meets the x axis. Okay. So the graph of a power x when a is greater than 1. This is the graph of a power x when a is greater than 1. So if you observe how the graph it is increasing function. Y is equal to a power x when a greater than 1. So when a greater than 1, how the graph? It is increasing graph. So that's why this function y is equal to a power x is an increasing function whenever a is greater than 1. Similarly, the graph of this a power x function, y is equal to a power x function when a is less than 1. When a is less than 1, the graph will be like this. So that means if you observe, the graph is what? Decreasing graph. That means the function y is equal to a power x is decreasing function when 0 less than a less than 1. So a power x function is increasing function when a greater than 1, and a power x, this exponential function a power x, is a decreasing function when a is less than 1. For example, If I take y is equal to 5 power x, it is an exponential function. Am I correct? So here, what is the base? 5. So 5 is greater than 1. So that means 5 power x is an increasing function. Then the graph of 5 power x is similar to this y is equal to a power x when a greater than 1. Okay. So graph of y is equal to 5 power x is similar to this graph. Okay. Suppose if I consider y is equal to 1 by 2 whole power x. 1 by 2 whole power x. Here what is a value? 1 by 2. A value 1 by 2. So which is less than 1. So the graph of y is equal to 1 by 2 whole power x is look like this. So then what kind of function it is? Decreasing function. Y is equal to 1 by 2 whole power x is decreasing function. Whereas y is equal to 5 power x is an increasing function. And also if you observe in both cases, the graph of this function is continuous. That means y is equal to a power x, this function is, it is continuous. Also, it is differentiable function. And also we know that what is the derivative of a power x? A power x into log a. Okay. But you have to remember the important point is when a greater than 1, a power x increasing function. When a less than 1, a power x function is decreasing function. Okay. Next. So next, coming to the lesson. So now I'm going to discuss logarithmic function. Okay, logarithmic function. So logarithmic function, one more name is inverse exponential function. Inverse exponential function. The inverse of exponential functions are nothing but logarithmic functions. The inverse of exponential functions is nothing but logarithmic functions. Okay, so the definition is, listen, suppose if a power y is equal to x, so to be understood here, a is positive other than 1 and y is any real number. So, but x is what kind of number? Positive number. Because a power y, x is nothing but a power y. A power y value, a power y value is always positive only, no? So that means x is always positive. Okay. If y, a power y is equal to x, if a power y is equal to x, then this exponent y, that exponent y, it is called logarithm of x, logarithm of x to the base a. This y is called, this exponent y is called logarithm of x to the base a. So thus the domain of this logarithmic function. So this log x to the base a is nothing but logarithmic function. Thus this, the domain of this logarithmic function is open interval 0 comma infinity, because log x, what is the argument of log function here? X. And what is, what kind of number x? Positive number. So that means here x takes only positive numbers. That means log function is defined only for positive real numbers. Thus the domain of log function is what? Open interval 0 comma infinity, nothing but set of positive real numbers. And range, and the range of this logarithmic function is set of all real numbers, set of all real numbers. Have to remember, see, a power y is equal to x. So as it is a definition, this is if and only if condition only. A power y is equal to x, then y is equal to what you are getting? Log of x to the base a. Log of x to the base a. This form is called exponential form. This form is called exponential form. Whereas this form is called logarithm form. This form is called logarithmic form. Okay. This form is exponential form. That form is logarithmic form. Okay. Some examples observe. What is 2 cube? 8. Then what is, this is the exponential form. Now I'm going to convert it into logarithmic form. So this exponent becomes, this exponent 3 becomes log of 8 base 2. Log of 8 base. So next time, if you take example, suppose 3 power minus 2 is equal to how much? 1 by 3 square. 1 by 3 square is nothing but 1 by 9. So thus, minus 2 is equal to what you will get? log of 1 by 9 to the base 3. Okay, next to one more example. So what is 4 power 0? Or you take a power 0. What is a power 0? It is equal to 1. So its logarithmic form is what? 0 is equal to log 1 to the base a. That means log of 1 with any permissible base is always equal to what? 0. Log 1 to the base a is 0. Next to, now in these three examples we converted exponential form to logarithmic form. Next I am going to convert logarithmic form to exponential form. So for example, we have like this, log of 10 to the base a is equal to 5. Okay, log 10 to the base a is equal to 5. Then convert it into exponential form. Then this 10 is equal to a power 5. 10 is equal to a power 5. So one more example. Say log 5 to the base a is equal to 2. Then this 5 is equal to what you'll get? 5 is equal to what you'll get? A square. So try to learn converting exponential form to logarithmic form and logarithmic form to exponential form. Okay. And now I'm going to discuss the graph of these logarithmic functions. So here also will arise two cases: when a greater than 1 case, a less than 1 case. So when a greater than 1, then I am going to draw the graph of y is equal to log x to the base a. Log x to the base a. When a greater than 1, the graph of log x to the base a will be like this. So just now we proved that log 1 is equal to what? 0. That means when x value 1, y value log 1 to the base a, which is 0. That means the graph crosses x axis at 1 comma 0 and never meets the y axis. The graph of log x to the base a meets the x axis at 1 comma 0 and never meets the y axis. Because exponential functions never meets the x axis, this is the inverse of exponential. So as that function never meets the x-axis, this function never meets the y-axis. So this is the graph of log function to the base a when a greater than 1. And second case, log function graph when a is less than 1. The log function graph when a is less than 1. So this is the graph of log x to the base a when a is less than 1. To be understood, it is greater than 0. Okay. So when a greater than 1, log function is also what? Increasing function. And when a less than 1, log function is decreasing function. Just two important definitions. So before that, I have to discuss what is e. So this e is called exponential constant. What we call exponential constant. Okay. And this e is an irrational number. It is an irrational number. It is an irrational number. Okay, so this e approximately, this e is nothing but what? What is e? So e is equal to, it is 1 plus 1 by x whole power x when x tends to infinity, or you can write as x tends to infinity. So as x tends to infinity, 1 plus 1 by x whole power x is tending to some real number. That real number itself only is called exponential constant, which is denoted by e. When x tends to infinity, this function is tending to some real number. That real number is nothing but e. So and is called what? Exponential constant. and its exponential constant approximately equal to 2.718 something. Okay, so this exponential constant can also be expressed as a series, infinite series. So this e is equal to 1 plus 1 by 1 factorial plus 1 by 2 factorial plus